Welcome to PC Mac. In today's video, we are going to talk about free and open source alternatives to Microsoft Office that we can install on Mac operating system. So let's do it. First of all, let's just go ahead and open the VirtualBox and open the Mac operating system. Now we are on the Mac operating system, as you can see. So let's go ahead and open Safari and show you the first package. The name of the software is OpenOffice and the website is openoffice.org. So let's go ahead and open it. And when you open it, it will take you to this page. What you need to do is just go ahead and click on download, and once you click on download, it will automatically detect the version, that is OSX 10.7, and the file extension is DMG. You just need to click on download full installation and it will be redirected to you to the SourceForge website. So I have already downloaded it, so let me just go ahead and close it from here. And now I'll take you to the second software that I want to show you. The name is libreoffice.org. This is the website and the name of the software is LibreOffice. Let's go ahead and hit enter, and as you can see, the website is right here. Let's click on download now and it will automatically detect your operating system, Mac OS X x86-64. You just need to click on download. If you have a torrent, you can go ahead and use the torrent file to download the LibreOffice. So I already downloaded both the offices. Let me just show you. Let me quit from Safari and go on to the download folder, and you can see both the office are right here. Let's go ahead and open the first one, and once you open it, you will see something like this. The interface is something like this. You just need to press and hold here and then drag it to the application folder. I already did that, so let's just stop it and close it from here. Now we'll go ahead and open the second one. It's again the same method, just double click on it. It will open the installation package for you and it will look like this. You just need to drag this LibreOffice to your application folder, and once it's done, it will again ask us to replace the file. We just click on stop to stop it. Let's just close this option and close this window as well. Let's just go ahead and eject both the packages from here. Now what we need to do is just click on go and click on applications, and then the first application that we have installed is OpenOffice. Let's just move to OpenOffice. It's right here. Let's go ahead and open it. Now once you open it, it will show you this configuration page. So let's just click on the next, and once we click on next, it will ask for the name. So let's just put PC Mac and initial Mr. PC Mac, and then click on finish. Once it's done, it will greet you with this opening page. From here, either you can go with the text document, that is the Word document in MS Office, spreadsheet is Excel, and a presentation stands for PowerPoint. And here is the database for Access, and the drawing is also there. So you can just go ahead and open the text document and maximize the page. By default, it will save the page to other format. It will not saving the page in doc format. So what we need to do is just click on file and we need to use save as. Once you see it, you can see it's using a ODF format, .odt extension. We just need to use the drop down and save it in doc format, so we can easily work on it on Office. If we want to send it to someone, we can easily do it from here, and we can easily create a PDF document. Let's just type something here, and when I did that, and you can see right here it says PDF, export directly as PDF. This is a cool feature of this software. Just click on it and it will ask you the place where you want to save. So let's just select desktop and save this file, and it will be directly converted to PDF. Let's just check, minimize it, and you will see the PDF document is right here. So let's just try to open it with the Safari so we can see that it's opening up correctly or not. As you can see, the PDF document is open. Let's just close it and let's just right click on it and then option keep in dock. So it's in dock now, and the next office that we have installed is LibreOffice. Let's just go on to it. It's right here, LibreOffice. Just go and double click on it, and once you double click on it, it will open like this, where writer document is the Word, calc spreadsheet is the Excel, and the presentation is again PowerPoint, then the drawing and math formula is the database. Sorry, the base database is the database, and these are two other options you can use. So if you want to go and use a spreadsheet, just click on it or just drag it onto the space and you can use it similar to the office, and you don't need to pay anything for these offices. So let's just go and close it and close it from here. So guys, that's it from my end. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.